वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सेकंड प्रॉब्लम व्हिच विल बी बेस्ड ऑन द फंक्शन जनरेशन मेथड. वी नो दैट इन अ फंक्शन वी विल गिवन वन इनपुट एंड वी विल बी गेटिंग वन आउटपुट. वी विल रिवर्स दिस प्रोसेस. वी विल बी डिजायरिंग वन आउटपुट एंड वी विल गेट द इनपुट इन दिस मेथड. सो इन दैट द क्वेश्चन वॉज, सो we have been given the coupler three positions. Okay, based on that we have the input angles, which is theta 1 2 and theta 1 3. This is one means with respect to the with respect to the first position, how much rotation is will be the 35 degrees, and with respect to the first position, our third position rotation should be 80 degrees. So if this part is for input and this part is for output, okay, where I am hovering the cursor, it's for output. Let me show you, this is for output, okay, and this is for input. So okay, we are ready with this our this thing. So I will show you this drawing I have drawn. Okay, this is my drawing. Okay, and here you can see the apparent different positions I have drawn in the another position. See, you can see the apparent other positions of this link. Means in the dotted lines you can see this one. Okay, and this one. Okay, so this is our three apparent location. You can clearly see in this how it will be going to rotate, and you can see the directions. You know the all the means all the links are itself a rigid body. Means the whole mechanism is not a rigid body, but the links is the rigid body, so it will follow the rules. Although this A B 1 and C 1 D will rotate by different angles, but the relative positions won't be changing. This is the main point I forgot to mention in the previous video. Okay, so what we will do, we'll start with the we will start taking the apparent and from the inputs. So we will follow the similar procedure, but here will be some change will be there. So we will see what change is there. So it's simple. So what we will take, that we will take the suitable A and D points, and we will join this, and we will shade it. This thing. We will shade it. This thing. Okay. So it will look as is a fixed link. Now what we will do? We will take the suitable C 1 point. You can see this C 1 point here. Okay. This suitable point. C1 here, and we will join the C1D point. Okay, and not to mention I forgot to mention all dimensions are in mm and scale is 1:2. Okay, so what we will take, we will not be scaled up or scaled down. So now we will take the thing, and as our question read, means that our output angles with respect to the first position was 15-80 degrees. So what we will do here, we will take the clockwise direction of rotation here. So we will take the reference of this, we will rotate by, you can see here 50 degrees and the next by 80 degrees, and we will join the D1 C3 and D C2. Okay, by dotted lines, and we will also join those C2 points with A1 and with A1 also. Okay, you can see AC3 and AC2, and this line and DC2 and DC3, both the lines will be same. You can cut the arc as I mentioned in the previous video from the taking C1 D as radius, and you can locate to C2, C3 required points. Okay. Now what we will do, we will rotate the same, we will take this as reference, A1, A is as a reference, which will be acting as our center, and we will take AC2 as a radius, and we will draw a arc like this, and we will take again this A as a center, and we will draw the second arc like this. Okay, I have drawn here, but this highlighted portion is not a mark. Sorry for that. And now you can see the this thing, light portion of this arc. Okay, not clearly visible because of the pose scanning. Okay, so what we will do here is we will rotate this. We will take AC2 as a reference. We will go in the opposite direction. Means we took the clockwise. We will take the anti-clockwise direction of this of this dotted lines. You can see here. So AC2 dash will be rotated by 35 degrees with reference to AC2, means we have given our rotation of second position with respect to the first position will be 35 degrees, and our rotation of third position with respect to the first position should be this thing. So our this length AC3 length and AC3 dash should be same. I told you na arc. Okay. So our AC2 dash should be same as AC2. Okay. So after this, what we will do? We will join the C1, C3 dash. And C1, C2 dash with dotted lines again, so as to not confuse with our original drawing. Okay, and now what we will do, we will draw perpendicular bisectors with taking C1, C2 dash and C1, C3 dash as references. So we will take perpendicular bisector, you can see NC1 denoted here. Now here denoted NC1 means perpendicular bisector from C1, C2 dash, and one perpendicular bisector from C1, C3 dash. We will join, we will extend this two perpendicular bisectors till we meet at V1. We will complete this diagram, and we will measure that length and take down the readings. Our this thing is, our readings are AV1 is 65 mm, B1 C1 is 35, C1 D is 50, AD 53 respectively. So what is change is there, in the previous we have to locate the extra point because as I have mentioned that it was a rigid body at that time. Here rigid body is not there, we have two points P1, C1, and another point I have mentioned. Okay, here it's clear. Yeah, but if you don't know the how to draw the perpendicular bisector, which I didn't explain in the previous video, what you will do, you will take the means suppose you have to draw the perpendicular bisectors between this C1 and C2 dash, what you will do, you will take any of this centers which I have highlighted as a center, and draw and cut an arc. You can take the radius more than half of the length of C1, C2, means of C1 highlighted distance between highlighted points and cut an arc. Then you again you take the C2 test point and take the same distance, cut an arc, and you will join those two points with the line. You will get the perpendicular bisector. So this ends our third problem. I will show you the again the apparent of whole bar mechanism working. Here it is showing the relative movement to trajectory of B1 point to B2 and then B3. See, and it is being highlighted with arc like this and this like this. Okay. And you can similarly highlight, you can similarly see this trajectory of C1 point like this up to C3 line. Why we need three positions? Because to locate a point, at least two lines should be joined. You have seen that we drew two normals now. In the previous video, I didn't explain that thing. I will explain it now. We need a point. A particular point means a particular length, so we can't draw unboundedly, so it will be looking ugly. So we will take three positions, we will take normals for that, and then draw it. We will see in the coming videos how it will be looking like when we take the motion as a prime movers. Okay, see you again in the next video. Bye. Thank you.